In this video, I'll show you how you can use the Baby Audio Parallel Aggressor to make a recording sound from this to this, by only using the Parallel Aggressor on individual tracks. Hi, I'm Marlon and welcome to the White Noise Studio. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell so you won't miss out on any new video on this channel, the channel to help you out in recording, mixing and mastering. Here's a completely untreated raw recording. As you can see here, I've used Parallel Aggressor on all tracks and on the drum bus. Here's with all Parallel Aggressors enabled, and this is without. Normally I would do more compressing and EQing, but it's interesting to hear that with only the Parallel Aggressor you can improve every track. I will go over how the Parallel Aggressor sounds and what it did on every individual track. If you want an overview of all the functions and controls of the Parallel Aggressor, check the link in the description below. Okay, let's check out the vocals. This is the raw vocal. And this is with the plugin. What it did was this. I pretty much enabled all knobs and played with the balance. So an all knobs in approach, and blended it in to add a solid, constant foundation to the vocal. The heat saturation was also all buttons in, and this is really saturated. I used the high and low pass to keep the saturation centered around the entire mid-range, and this will enhance the presence when blended in. Here's the bass guitar. And here the Parallel Aggressor sounds really nice too. Same approach, all buttons in. Here you can also hear well what the tone knob is doing. Guitars. On this guitar, I didn't go all buttons in, as you can see. The saturation needs to be way more subtle, and the spank and heat are not dialed up to the max. It's more subtle for this guitar, but it still adds a nice body. This is before, and this is after. On the second guitar, it's the heat all over and less compression, as in all extra buttons are turned off. This is before, and here's after. And what about drums? Here they are, before and after. I went more subtle with the snare, since the smack can add a really pointy attack, as you can hear. That does not fit this snare very well, so I'm backing off the smack here. I have added a little heat to add some saturation, which brings out the snares of the snare drum, and all high passes are enabled. For the kick, I went for more attack and point. So the smack button is on and the heat is off. This is before and this is after. For overheads, I did something of everything to have more body, to have the cymbals and toms more in balance. No extra smack or punch. I did give it extra saturation and all high passes are on. I also added the plugin to the drum bus. This is without, and this is with. Here I added extra smack to pull the attack of kick and snare more towards each other, and added a little bit of saturation. So let's hear it in total. Here is without all instances of Parallel Aggressor, and this is with the Parallel Aggressor enabled on all channels. As you could hear, the Parallel Aggressor can also be used on separate tracks to beef up audio, add body, and fixate audio really into a spot. I would absolutely do more EQ and go more in depth with compression settings on each track. The Parallel Aggressor can also work as a finishing touch on individual tracks, on group buses and on the master bus, like I showed in my review. And now for the most important part, did you remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video? And hit that notification bell so you know when there's a new video to help you out. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!